Viva Las Vegas. Viva Las Vegas.
How I wish that there were more than 24 hours in the day.
You sound like you're in a good mood, yes? Oh, good. Well, I'm always in a good mood in Las Vegas. And you know why I think it's the perfect place to come? Because I don't care where you're from. Las Vegas is the opposite of it.
Vegas is a very special place, and the people who come to Vegas experience things that they experience no place else. So when I talk about, when I do my show in Vegas, it is a bit different from the show I do on the road, because I've got to mention that there's a place where you can take a gondola to the Gap.
Yeah, because gambling's legal, prostitution's legal. I guess the jails here are just full of people who litter. You know what else I love? I love the neon. Isn't it pretty? Yeah, Las Vegas is the only town where as the sun goes down, it gets lighter.
I was dancing professionally on Broadway by the time I was 15. And then I did 6 Broadway shows from 15 to 25. And then my feet hurt, so I started to talk. And then I became a comedian. And I don't know why, because I was in therapy and I forgot to ask.
I get to tell you all of my problems tonight. Do you know why? Because I have a microphone.
Well, when you're growing up, you never really think that anything that happens is going to happen. I know my parents, when they were raising me, maybe thought I would be a dancer, my father's a lawyer, maybe a lawyer, maybe a doctor. I never thought they said, you know, I wonder if someday Rita will be a slot machine.
Oh, my gosh. This past summer, it got up to 7,000 degrees. And some people, it doesn't bother them. Hottest day of the year, this woman, she's just out there sunbathing by the pool. I could tell she was done. Her belly button had popped up.
One of my, most recognizable jokes was, if I never want to see a man again, I don't ever tell him I don't want to see you again. I just say, I love you. I want to marry you. I want to have your children. Sometimes they leave skid marks.
Guys, you're going to learn so much about women tonight. We'll do anything to stop the wrinkles. My aunt had herself laminated.
Men and women in relationships are the body of my act and what I talk about. So wherever I go, there's still either a man or a woman or both men and women. So I'm okay.
You're not supposed to go in the sun. It's bad for you. It's supposed to make your skin leathery and wrinkly and old. Sometimes I look at those gorgeous 16-year-old girls just baking themselves on the beach and think, fry, you homewreckers, fry!
Men take things more personally. Women are, you know, we've been hearing my wife's so fat for the last, you know, 50 years or whatever. We don't think it's me that's fat. We think the guy's wife is fat. So, women were easier to make laugh, and now men have evolved into a state when they're as ready to laugh at themselves.
I like the pirate ships out front of the Treasure Island. Once an hour they sink a British ship, which is fun for everyone except for my husband, because he's British. So everyone else cheered, and he tried to join the cast and change the outcome of the 5 o'clock show.
My husband, who I met because he produces comedy shows, he's the funniest guy I know, and he's funny during the day still, and I'm still only funny from like 8 to 9:20 at night when I perform.
Another reason I love these hotels, I appreciate them, because I was on the road for a long time and I stayed in motels. And I have to tell you something, that one letter makes a big difference.
People have asked me where I got my delivery and my style, and it's the same as who I am in person. I mean, this is the way I talk. I did concentrate on not sounding like a comedian, because there's a certain comedic rhythm that is very generic, and it's people when they go ba-dum-bum, and then they lay very heavy on the end of the joke, and that's fine, you know, that's a way to do it, but I didn't want to do it that way.
I don't know how much to tip people, but I'm not the only one, am I? No, I just give people money, and if they look too happy, I take some back.
I like to phrase my jokes so people come to me, rather than I just kind of lay it out to them.
I love that it's 24/7. It's the only town where at 3 a.m. you can hear someone say, I'm going to lunch. It's the only town a performer gets to see her name on a big marquee with food. I don't think that's fair. I can't compete with roast beef for $3.95.
I love for people to feel like they've had a connected experience. Like I know them and they know me, and I've had friends over to my home. I love when I do jokes where people relate to them, when the wives go like this to the husbands, you do that, and husbands go like this to the wives.
Have you seen the dancing waters in front of the Bellagio? Aren't they beautiful? Oh, I love them, but I only see half the show and then I have to go to the bathroom.
I just want people to have the best time they can possibly have for an hour and a half.